The vast destruction of Al-Shifa Hospital in Gaza has been laid bare following the withdrawal of Israeli forces. Hundreds of people have returned to the complex following the two-week-long raid. Bodies are being pulled from the ruins and laid to rest. The World Health Organization reports at least 21 patients died. Many were moved and unable to receive proper care. Israel's Defense Force hailed the operation as a success, claiming it killed more than 200 militants in and around the compound. They arrested more than 900 suspects and say more than 500 are affiliated with Hamas and the Palestinian Islamic Jihad groups.
Hamas destroyed and ruined the Shifa Hospital after it turned it into a military headquarters. There were more terrorists in the hospital than patients or medical staff.
Hamas released video during the raid of its fighters firing at Israeli troops inside the hospital complex. Meanwhile, Iran is vowing to respond harshly to an Israeli airstrike on its consulate building in Syria's capital, which killed one of its senior commanders. Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guards Corps confirmed two of its generals and five officers are among the dead. At least two Syrian police officers have also been wounded. Rescue crews are combing through debris of the building, which has been reduced to rubble.
Definitely the Zionist regime knows better than anyone that such crimes and violating international law will have its response in an appropriate time.
Israel's military says it does not comment about foreign media reports. So as the Palestinian death toll nears 33,000 in 6 months, anti-government protesters have taken to Israel's streets in the biggest demonstration since October 7. They're angry their government hasn't secured the release of hostages and they want Prime Minister Netanyahu to resign. An Israeli rabbi in training who survived the October 7 attacks is among those critical of Israel's military operation. Avi Dabush is in Australia on a speaking tour calling for peace and joins us now at the desk. Avi, thank you so much for joining us in the studio. Mm-hmm. What are Israeli citizens thinking about their government 6 months on from October 7?
Mm-hmm. Actually, we can see on polls that they are not really supportive of this coalition and this government, and they want to replace it. Again, from many types of reasons, but right now we can see it doesn't get any support.
And these demonstrations that we saw over the weekend were huge, tens of thousands of people taking to the streets.
Yeah, it's a combination of the hostages' families, which is, of course, really important to all of us. I'm coming from a kibbutz that still have two hostages in Gaza. But also it's the democracy demonstration that were very big till October 7th that now combined and become a real massive demonstrations.
Avi, five people from your kibbutz are being held hostage. Five others were killed. Mm-hmm. You hid from Hamas by sheltering on October 7th. Yeah. And that's the way that you and your family survived. You hid for 8 hours from Hamas. So how do you emerge from something like that advocating for peace?
It's a good question. I believe, or in my values, it's, of course, have a deep connection because this is the only way. Peace is the only way. And even if we have, of course, the right to defend ourselves, and it is important, it's also a human right, you know, security and life of people. The end goal and the value, it's peace. We talked about, if I mentioned Judaism, this is one of the names of God, Shalom, peace. It's one of the names of God. So we are obligated to that, even more in those harsh times.
You speak about deep and radical dehumanizing from both sides. Mm. Is that entrenched thinking over decades or something that has come about after October 7?
It became worse since October 7th. And from our perspective of rabbis for human rights, we can see it as a central issue of the dignity of people and the equality of people, actually, as creations of God, or even, as themselves, as universal value. So it becoming worse and worse. We could see it in October 7th with the Hamas attack, with the Hamas horror massacre, but also right now with the things and perspectives of Jews against Arabs all around the area.
Avi, as Executive Director of Rabbis for Human Rights, you've been outspoken in your criticism of Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories. Is that where the solution lies here, two states?
Generally, yeah. As an organization, actually, we don't have a perspective about the specific diplomatic solution. I'm part myself in the movement A Land for All, which holds the idea of confederation, you know, two-state solution, but with open borders. But as Rabbis for Human Rights, as a human rights organization, we believe that we must be in another place in terms of violations of human rights. So the occupation, of course, is a big root and central root of violations of human rights of the Palestinians. And this is important for us as Jewish, as Jews and that held this Jewish perspective, but also as a universal human rights perspective.
Avi, just finally, we have some breaking news about an Australian aid worker that has been killed in Gaza. What does that say about this conflict when aid workers and journalists and humanitarian workers are killed?
Yeah, this is, of course, terrible for all of us. And it shows another time the limits of power. You know, if we believe that power is the end goal and the solution, it's not like that. We really believe that sometimes you have to use power, but it's not the solution. And we ask our government again and again, what's the solution? What's the end goal? And we believe again in values of peace, of human rights, of equality and justice. And we support that and push for that.
All right, Avi Dabush, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.